Jesus pisha se mai pre. Today my topic is for the short message is the role of youth in gospel. What is gospel? The gospel is the singularly most important communication of God to man. In Jesus, who is God the Son, we have the revelation of God's love and sacrifice that saves us from the God righteous judgment upon sins. The Bible tells us what the gospel is. For over that, we can take 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verses 1-4. Now, brothers, I want to remind you of the gospel I preached to you, which you received on which you have taken your stand. By this gospel you are saved, if you hold firmly to the word I preached to you, otherwise you have believed in vain. For what I received I pass on to you for as of first importance. The Christ died for our sins according to the scripture, and he was buried, that he was raised on the third day according to the scripture. We are in a world that is so busy and not to be. Young people are the easiest way to reach with the gospel to the bride of the Christ. This is not only stated in the scripture, Ecclesiastes chapter 12 verses 1 and Proverbs chapter 22 verses 6, but in also empirical fact. The purpose of youth ministry is to point youth towards God and help them become involved in the Great Commission. In the Bible, Paul the Apostle was an apostle who taught the gospel of Christ to the first century world. Paul says in Philippians chapter 1 verses 21. In these words, we see entire the substance of the apostle's life and what he looked for his life. Everything that Paul did evolved around his Lord whom he saved. Here I want to say that they say 10 things that young people can do for God and gain life's greatest blessings. First one is to obey the gospel of Christ. In it, Christ commands us to believe in him. It is written on John chapter 8 verses 24. Second one is to repent of our sins. It's written on Acts 22 verses 38. And to confess his name, it is written on Matthew chapter 10 verses 32-33. And to be baptized into him for the remission of our sins. It is written on Romans chapter 6 verses 3-6. The second one is keep yourself pure. It's written on 1 Timothy chapter 5 verses 22. Third one is build a Christian personality. Fourth one is lead others to Christ. In this, Christ commands his disciples to take the gospel to everyone. You can be a soul winner. Next, fifth one is get a Christian education. Sixth one is prepare yourself for a decent profession. Seventh one is build a Christian leadership. Ninth one is encourage and help others. Tenth one is be faithful throughout your life. Now I would like to say the five important roles of your youth ministry. First one is consumer. Indeed, one who looks for users for and uses lessons, activities, events and soul connections. Second one is the creator. Creator, one who creates, shares, improves the lessons and leads or fuel commissions. Third one is the connector. One who helps one another to understand and get connected to other and activities. Fourth one is the carrier, one who takes the group way and of group way of life to other groups through various forms of communication. And the last, the fifth one is the caretaker, one who cares for the needs of the group. At last, the most important part of my of your service will be your own daily spiritual preparation, including prayers, scripture study and obedience to the commandments. I encourage you to dedicate yourself to living the gospel with greater purpose than ever before.